The bear conceals everything. There are a few more people to come in, so we'll just require to start the guided meditations this afternoon. As usual, we just bring our awareness into the here and now. being here. As we zoom in, and I hear the sound of the wind outside, I remember some of those monasteries up in mountains, where the wind howls, but I'm inside my hut, or a cave, inside my body, inside my mind, a place where the winds don't move my mind. Like Ajahn Chah's simile, as a leaf on a tree. It only moves because of the wind. But here, inside, nothing makes my mind move. I notice as soon as the mind just goes out slightly, out into the future, out to the back to the past, my mind is open to the wind and it trembles. Right now there's peace. Buddha called this inside the present moment, inside your body-mind. He called that the cave of the heart, Hadiya Guha. It's an inner cave where you feel safe, protected. That's where bears live, in caves. So that's why I made friend with the bear today. Sitting together in the cave of the heart. I don't pay any interest to where I come from, no more than I can trace where the wind has come from. I can only hear its sound, the sound of now. I don't know where we'll go to. It's not my business to follow the sound, to follow the wind. If I follow the wind, I blow about all over the place. I remain still and rooted in this wonderful, peaceful, present moment with my bear. I feel so safe in my little cave. I have nothing to worry about. Know that the future is always made right now. Peace can only be found in this very moment. When I go out searching, I leave my peace. So I stay here content, easily satisfied. Not proud and trying to get something to show off. Easily satisfied. Not demanding anything. I ask for nothing in the world. Just being peaceful. Even just focusing on peace. I look at my body, it's already relaxed. Often it relaxes itself. I'm just looking at my mind. No work to do. No place to go. Nothing to change, nowhere to, no one to meet. No appointments, no deadlines. I work hard in my life to get to a place like this, a place where I can truly relax and just cough. Now is the most important time. This experience which I have right in front of me now, hearing myself speak or holding a teddy bear or watching the breath, this experience, whatever it is the most important in the whole world, because it's not what you're aiming for, it's not what you are looking back, burdened with. It's what's actually happening now. In meditation, we don't look at repeats, repeat programs. We don't look forward to see what's coming up next. We give total importance to this moment and to what's right in front of our mind. That is the only meditation object. And one which is happening right now. Whatever it is. If it's difficult to bear, remember it's teaching you something and it will change by itself. It won't last. We need to be with it. To get to know. To get understanding and insight. What this moment is trying to teach us. And what do? We care for it. We open the door of our heart to this moment. No matter what this moment is, it's pleasant, unpleasant, in between. Happening now, that's why it's important, that's why it's our primary meditation object. And all we do is embrace it with respect and care. Pleasant, unpleasant. Remember the story of Mother Teresa picking up stinky, smelly, decaying people with cancer in the Calcutta streets. Disgusting. But she couldn't see the disgust. She just cared. This moment now, you care for this moment. Embrace it, be with it, respect it. Changes by itself, if you care for it. If you want to live in a house of peace, you have to build the house, brick by brick. One moment of peace, after another moment of peace, after another moment of peace. That's all you ever can do. Make peace with this moment, and after a while you found you're living in a huge mansion built of many moments of peace. If you want to live in a kind house, a house of love and non-discrimination, acceptance, you have to make many moments of opening the door to kindness, non-judgment, respect. So I'm kind to this moment, I'm caring for it. No matter what it is. Care, the more easier it is to care. And I have a help, teddy bear. Bear awareness, having a bear on your lap helps you. Evokes kindness, simplicity, safety, and a little bit of warmth too. Just in this moment, not going anywhere, not aiming for anything, not trying to get someplace I'm not already sitting in. I want peace, not have to go anywhere. I want satisfaction, not having to achieve anything. I want rest, not having to strive. You strive when you get back home later tomorrow. Now, strive free self, calm now. And all my awareness is on this moment, whatever it is, adding kindness. Everything else tends to become settled and calm. Your breathing often becomes easy to see. If it's not the breathing, it could be some irritation in your body or the sound of the wind outside. Whatever it is, don't try and get rid of it. Care for it. Just come into your awareness. To teach you something. The teachers of nature. When we try and get rid of it to go somewhere else, when we don't pay it respect and attention, we lose wonderful opportunities to learn from nature as it is. But my breath is dominant now. Just caring for the breath. Breath, you are my friend, like my teddy bear. Come in, go out. And I respect you, breath. I care for you. You may not always be comfortable, but I embrace you. With my breath, caring for it, never trying to cure it. With my mind, whatever stage of meditation, I'm not going to judge you, push you, cajole you for being a laggard in meditation practice. Just going to be with you, kind. Whenever you want to get deep, that's up to you, not me. I'm just going to be here, caring for you. Every now and again I remember my peaceometer. How peaceful are you? Mind. It's amazing that when I don't strive, don't get disappointed. When I lower my expectations, I find I'm already home. I'm just here. Being peace. Very pleasant having nothing to do and not trying to fill in the spaces with something to distract myself. The present moment is not a bad place to be. It's really nice. Resting, being. I notice the mind becomes happier. It's a beautiful happiness of content, meant. If the happiness is not there for you, smile. And as soon as I make a smile on my face, it has a link to my psychology. When my face smiles, my mind has a little bit of happiness. And that happiness is like a striking a match on dry tinder, and my mind lights up. The recognition that I don't have to do anything. Peace. Savoring this moment. Breath just coming in, cough going out. Trying to let my body be my body, not controlling it, certainly not developing it. Letting it be. Breathing in peace. Breathing in joy. Remembering inspiration. Breathing in. Inspired. And breathe out. Relax. Let go. Stop holding things. Quiet now, just being peaceful. approach to the end of meditation now. How do you feel? Peace upon peace upon peace. But don't judge good or bad. Just know and care for this moment.